There is a growing trend of research in neuropsychological assessment in Korea, along with other Asian countries, for the purpose of screening and diagnosis of dementia or related disorders in the elderly population. First of all, recent therapeutic advances to delay the progression of dementia have renewed calls to improve early detection and management of individuals with dementia. In recent development of dementia assessments, the developers are more mindful that the entire battery needs to be brief and applicable to a fully educated elderly population. The development of assessment tools basically followed the stages of direct translation, adaptation of Western instruments, and the construction of original assessment tools. As tests are translated or adapted for use in Korean population, the issue of cross-culture validity arises. In other words, social and cultural factors affect some aspects of test performance. I am going to give one example as an evidence that cultural differences beyond the simple demographic factors may affect performance of older adults on verbal fluency tasks. One verbal fluency task asked older Korean adults to generate items found in a supermarket. Often, Korean clients do more poorly on this verbal fluency task than counterpart US adults of same age and same educational background. Their slower, poor retrieval may be due to their limited familiarity with supermarkets, which are not the primary shopping venues of Korean older adults. Based on new research findings and increased recognition of the impact of cultural factors, most of recently adapted assessments work on clinically validating their items and administration procedures, often including replacing original items with culturally relevant ones and establishing new norms for Korean elderly population. Mini-mental state examination is most widely used for the assessment of cognitive functioning for Korean elders too. The original MMSE was translated and modified into two Korean versions. One is called MMSE-K and another is called K-MMSE. These versions can give a perfect example of how, sorry, okay, I will repeat another previous sentence. I'm sorry. These two Korean versions can give a perfect example of how the original assessment was adapted to be appropriate for Korean population. I'm going to focus on one version, MMSE-K, today. You can check out another version, K-MMSE, in the bibliography we provided. There were two purposes of the modification. First, there was an urgent need to develop neuropsychometric measures. They can sensitively and specifically identify people with cognitive impairment in non-Western, non-English, only Korean-speaking population. Second, there were a number of intrinsic problems which made it difficult to use with people with low education and illiteracy. The illiterate cannot perform two of the original MMSE test items. One was to write a sentence about anything, and another was to read the written instruction of close your eyes. These are the test items of the MMSE-K. In the original MMSE, the item 10 is close your eyes. It was changed to comprehension test. Why do people wash their clothes? Any response regarding hygiene was considered correct and given a score of 1 point. The original test item 11 here was originally write a sentence about anything, which was changed to a judgment item. How can you give an identity card back to the owner if you find it on the street? Here, the item 7 was originally to repeat no ifs, ands, or buts, but which was changed to a Korean phrase. And word WORLD in spelling backward in the original item 4 was changed to Samcheolli Gangsan, which means All Korea Beautiful and is 5-syllable word. MMSEK contains 30 possible points like the original MMSE. In scoring, the responses by the lunar calendar to the first item, orientation in time, are also correct because the lunar calendar is widely used among Koreans. In the Park and Kwon's study on the validation of MMSEK, education was the only variable influencing scores. So the raw MMSEK score was corrected for education by adding 1 point to the score on orientation in time, 2 points to the score on concentration calculation, and 1 point to the score on language function of non-educated individuals. However, the corrected score should not be more than the possible maximum score in a given sphere. For scoring, another study estimated the optimal cutoff score for MMSEK for screening of dementia in community-dwelling old people and possible changes of the cutoff score according to age, gender, educational level, living area, and depression of the old people. In the older people 65 and over, the optimal cutoff score on MMSEK served by clinical diagnosis of dementia was 21-22. Age was significantly related to the cutoff score on MMSEK. The author suggested the optimal cutoff score in those ages 75 or over was to be 20-21. This study suggests community healthcare staff can use demographically or culturally appropriate cutoff score on MMSEK for screening of dementia as a guideline for assessing old people with questionable cognitive dysfunction or for considering to consult them to an expert. Many systematic systems for diagnosing and classifying Alzheimer's and Alzheimer disease and other dementias are also available for use in Korean population. Here you can see some examples of assessment tools for dementia which were clinically validated with Korean population. For example, the first one, the CRAD battery, which was developed by the consortium to establish a registry for Alzheimer's disease and is one of the most widely used assessments, has also been adapted to be used with Koreans. The last two assessments, here IQ-CODE and K88, have often used in various clinical settings to identify earlier stages in the disease through interviewing with potential patients, families, and friends on identified person's possible cognitive decline from prior state and interference with his or her daily life. Of course, these do not comprise a complete list of clinically validated assessments for use in Korean elderly, nor are equally valid and reliable for different groups of Koreans. However, I want to mention that Korean population has been increasing and this trend seems to continue in this century. Psychologists and health practitioners in the United States are more likely to encounter clients who are born and brought up in Korea. It will be important to be aware of how cognitive impairment or dementia is detected and diagnosed, or more generally, cognitive processes are assessed in Korea, and what testing instruments are available and suitable for assessing Korean or Korean-American clients. Last, I would like to briefly mention some issues in assessment of dementia with the Korean population. Test items, format, or administration should be carefully reviewed and adapted, culturally and demographically appropriate. Test results also need to be scored and interpreted with the characteristics of the Korean population in mind. Especially lower education level seems to influence the cognitive screening. Dementia is a general decline of pre-existing cognitive capacities. The elderly in low education group may not have developed their cognitive capabilities sufficiently, and the sensitivity to dementia's assessment procedure could be lower for the low education group. It is also very important to develop tools to detect early dementia or psychoeducate early signs of dementia to be able to be diagnosed for early detection of the disease. The early detection will enable patients to receive a proper treatment earlier and better, and their caregiving families to reduce the great burden of dementia care. Informant interview or informant-based measurement of early dementia may be also helpful for older Korean Americans.